There's many steps that need to be taken to confront the surge of populism, right-wing radicalism, bigotry, hatred, nationalism. The list is so long. So we need to not just start now, we should have started yesterday. I think none of us expected this amount of backlash, in a way, to the vision of a unified Europe, to the vision of a very strong transatlantic alliance. Steps that can be taken by organizations like the American Jewish Committee, like the Friedrich Naumann Foundation, include working very closely with government. This is a case of public-private partnership that needs to be strengthened much more than it was before. Civil society needs to be strengthened in many, many, many countries. And even in countries where we assume that it's strong, never take democracy for an assumption.
I think the first and foremost thing to realize is that the bigots and racists are not necessarily bad people, so we don't have to think they are stupid, they are uneducated, because then we will create an even bigger gap, and that is not necessarily a good thing. Many of these people are mistaken, of course, but they are not necessarily people who cannot be argued with, because in a lot of cases these people haven't met any minorities. They don't know, they have never met any Jewish people or Roma people or anyone. For example, in Hungary right now, immigration is a huge problem, but it's clear that people who have met refugees and immigrants are more tolerant of ours than people who think of them as an abstract.
I think that's the beauty of liberalism. It's all about individual human beings and their choices and their freedoms and respecting them, individuals. Not collective rights, not group rights where the individual differences are lost, but every single, each one of those human beings matters. Their security matters, their freedom matters, their interests matter. I think that's the answer.